Hello to all my people, and if you're watching on YouTube or checking it out on your favorite podcast provider, you are most definitely my people. Welcome to another episode of BotchBots and Chair Shots. I'm your host, a chef by trade and a mark by choice. I am the Will Gray, and today we have a very special guest. Joining me today, ahead of the STP Takeover event, we've got the Vice President and CEO of Shane Taylor Promotions. He is a mogul beyond wrestling. He is Reverend Ron Hunt. Ron, how are you, sir?
Not bad. How about yourself? Thank you for having me on.
Man, I'm super excited to have you. Let's just go ahead and dive right into it. I'm going to say three words to you, and I want you to tell me how you feel about them. Bodega Street Fight.
Chopped cheese.
Chopped cheese. How are you feeling? How are you feeling ahead of your match tonight with Jay Bougie?
I'm feeling like this, man. He keeps bragging about this chopped cheese, and that's how I explain it just in regards of my emotion, because it makes him happy. So that means that the rev is happy. I'm trying to get this whole New York lingo. It's a whole nother vibe out here. But what I've been able to understand is this. The New York people come out for their people. So I think that this is going to have Jay Bougie have a little bit of home field advantage, which I appreciate that. It's going to make the challenge even deeper for me. But at the same time, I know I'm going to have to dig in deeper than I probably ever have, because it's a young man that really wants it. And I respect that. But at the end of the day, he's going to learn how to respect me. And when it's going to come down to it is, I'm not going to stop at anything. By any means necessary, I will drag him to hell and back. So if he's ready for that, if he feels that can happen, step up to the plate, man. Time is ticking. We're just hours away, man.
So as we're staring down the barrel of it, we've got three big matches. One for every member of STP, one for every member of TakeOver. There's more than wins and losses here on the line. We're talking about pride. Can you speak a little bit about what's on the line between you and Bougie with this match?
I think it's as simple as this. He wants to represent for his people. He wants to represent for his team TakeOver. You already know what we've been doing for the last few years, representing for Shane Taylor Promotions and also representing for the people, but on the grander level. And if you want to be audacious enough to step up to the plate, then this goes beyond just a wrestling match. I feel like all of the fans, all the people that's going to be watching on IWTV Live tonight on pay-per-view starting at 7, you're going to see a battle of will. These are two lions and cubs going against each other, the whole team of itself, to see who is going to be the true leader of the Serengeti. So you absolutely said it right. It's about pride. It's about respect. And legacies are on the line. Are they going to step up to ours? Are they going to try to take everything that we've gained? We'll see.
So what does Shane Taylor Promotions mean to Reverend Ron Hunt, to be the right hand of the baddest man on the planet, the baddest of all time?
Absolutely, man. Family. I think there's no other way to put that. We always try to tell people we are not machine made. We made ourselves. We are self-made. And something happens when you are self-made. You have to go through the trenches just to get your share portion. So everything that we've gone through together is bonded that bond together, and it made us even a deeply rooted family. So that's where it all starts. There's no foundation of family. I don't think that you have what you see today, as in the strength of Shane Taylor Promotions here in 2022 right now.
So IWTV has been a super big asset for you guys leading up to this event. It's going to be, as you said, broadcasted through everybody through their streaming service. How big of an asset do you think IWTV has become for the indie scene as a whole, now with this being this mothership of content for everybody?
I think it's an absolute, it's a big opportunity. It's a big opportunity. Like I told everyone, I shared it on my social media, on Twitter and everything else toward that extent. I said, listen, you guys are going to have to understand that also while we are there, this is also a show that you are a part of. You know, while the marquee might be the marquee, you are every bit a part of this. And we want to bring that notoriety to people that maybe have never had eyes on them. So in their way, this is almost like that prerequisite that we want them to get out there to a deeper audience and then connect on that and keep your career going up. So with platforms like IWTV, I think this is a magnificent opportunity for anybody on the independents to get an opportunity to have further eyes on you that might have taken you way longer if you would have went through it the traditional way, like a lot of us went through 10, 15, 20, 30 years ago.
So coming out of COVID, a lot of people got it rough the last couple of years. Do you think indie wrestling is starting to thrive again now that we're coming on the backside of COVID and we're starting to gain some normality?
Absolutely. You know, I think that's one of the biggest things, and I really think that it aligned people's focus. I think, you know, sometimes pre-COVID, you know, you probably had some opportunities where people were just coming. But you always realize that you don't know how much you're going to miss something until it's gone. And I think that resonated with a lot of fans, that when the opportunity came, hopefully now on the back end of this pandemic, you know, fans are truly appreciating the art of professional wrestling and the passion that they individually have for professional wrestling. And I really think that it made the bond even stronger. So I do see a bright future ahead for the sport of professional wrestling.
Do you currently watch any of the big three, so to speak? Are you watching any modern wrestling, like, live on TV right now?
You know, I dabble here and there. You know, I think that's one of the things. Always keep your eyes open to what's out there. And, you know, while we think we have some good future competition for us in any of the big three, and all of those are opportunities, absolutely. But at the same time, on the back end, we also have a lot of friends in those companies as well that we're like, listen, it'll be really good to mix it up with you guys and just create further art in the sport of professional wrestling. So I keep my eyes open. I do watch some things here and there, man. And you know, I got to say, you know, I'm a connoisseur of the sport myself. I'm very passionate about it, so I am going to watch these different areas. And I say, at the end of the day, you don't need to hate one company to support another. You can love all three of them. You can love all four, five, six, however many national companies you watch. You can love them all at the same time. Just learn to support the sport of professional wrestling as a whole.
So there's something to be said about being on the indie circuit, because you're not going to have – that's kind of a double-edged sword. You don't get the big-time contracts that you would from an AEW or WWE, but you also get a lot of times that creative freedom and control on your whole schedule and where you're booked and how you're booked a lot of times. How do you feel about having that kind of freedom with your career?
You know, I think it's one of those things that, you know, to definitely, you know, enjoy it while you can. You know, I think it's one thing to be like, hey, you know, let me just go hard for maybe about 6 or 7 months. Let me take a couple of months off, you know, and have a little bit of that freedom. And then at the same time, it kind of, you know, works a little bit further around your schedule and everything toward that extent. But at the same time, you know, I think that everyone does want to get a taste. I don't think any of us would be in this business if we didn't want to get a taste of whatever we thought that higher, more national level is, to, you know, also bringing more income and everything like that. So, you know, I think it's one of those things that when you really look at it, it kind of matures with your thought process as you continue to grow in the business, to just really examine and say, hey, you know, do I think I can put a good, you know, 300 plus days on the road right off the jump? Am I prepared for that? Am I mentally prepared for that? You want to talk, you want to think about all those things. And then as you see, and you begin to look at those deeper things outside of the national notoriety with the TV companies, then you're like, okay, I can now pick my decisions from the back end instead of just looking at all the glitter that's on the front. You take a deeper aspect into that.
What's the number one thing you like to do when you get home after you've been on the road to relax and decompress?
Sleep. No. I think that's an obvious. You know, I definitely say it's just one of those things to just be able to just like, I'm weird with it, but like sit on the back porch or something like that and just chill, you know, get a cup of coffee, get a cigar or something like that and just relax. Cause you know, I think anyone that's been doing a few things will tell you sometimes the easiest thing you just want to see is just peace and hear nothing. You know, that's why you see Dwayne and Rock Johnson with a ranch out in the middle of nowhere. Stone Cold has a ranch, you know, sometimes you just need that peace and tranquility. So even just that, to just really let everything that you've been going through kind of think about it so you can appreciate it in the now moment. So just give yourself that time to just breathe and think about it and be grateful for, you know, how you got to that point.
So now looking at it from a business perspective, though, you're just a couple hours away from the bell tolling and you guys going live. How are you preparing for the rest of your day leading up to such a brutal battle?
Yeah, you know, I definitely say it's one of the focuses, and you know, I'm a big person about energy, so you don't want anyone to take away from your energy. But if you think that people can add to your energy, you know, leading up to that, you know, keep them around so you keep a good strong force, man. So, you know, I definitely roll with my crew from the Pittsburgh area. We came up here. The rest of Shane Taylor Promotions is here or somewhere on the way. Just talked to Big Shane T yesterday, and I think our whole camp is looking at the aspect of, you know, it's game time. We're in the tunnel, we see the fog, we're chilling, get, you know, just stay in that mindset and don't let anything break from that mindset until after the second bell rings. So right now there's that tension, but it's a good tension that kind of keeps you focused and well-rounded leading into tonight.
So looking at the match as a whole and looking at the event as a whole, what's next for Reverend Ron Hunt after tonight? What do you have coming down the barrel?
Yeah. I say we definitely keep it climbing. You know what I'm saying? You know, a lot of things that we have done, bro. We have some things a little bit, you know, later in the year that I can't really talk about right now. But you know, a couple of other things that's also happened is just, you know, really trying to get to as many of these areas as possible so we can get some more eyes. I think that's been my big thing. I've just always been trying to give back. You know, if anyone has a question, I'm always trying to willing to give back. And so really just taking this time to build a firm foundation, hit as many of these companies as I can and work who they deem as the best in those companies and make them better, and then hopefully leave something with that company or they share something with me that I can take to somewhere else. So it's really that healing of the independent wrestling scene. I'm hitting all companies, a bunch of companies here in Pittsburgh. We have Eclipse Pro Wrestling, I'm one of their heavyweight champions. Fight Underground, one of their heavyweight champions, and a company called Pit Underground, one of their champions. And then going out to some other areas and doing some things there. So my thing is with this, I have three titles. I got open communication. I want to fight one of your biggest for one of the titles, and they can pick which title is going to be on the line. That's what I do. So I want to do that to build these areas and put some more eyes on some people. And if they take it from me, even bigger eyes. So I welcome all challengers.
So I'm an old head of sorts. I grew up in the early 90s, lots of the NWA, the territory days, stuff like that.
Oh, man, you calling that an old head? Oh.
Early 90s, it seems, I guess, to a lot of...
I guess we're slight old heads, man.
We're in that in between. We're not quite old heads, but we're definitely not the young bucks anymore. You know what I mean? Like, we're somewhere in between. But growing up in that era, a lot of those territory titles were prestigious. They were huge to hold, and you currently hold three of them. What does it mean for you for a promotion to trust you enough to carry their gold?
Absolutely, and I think that's the main thing about it. You know, I don't really think wins and losses really matter. You know, as long as you have whatever your inner being is fighting for, you're putting that on the line, okay? And like, I've gone to every match as it's a match of pride. It's not about wins and losses. It's about that inner fight that we're getting out there. So, you know, to be able to then, you know, like you said, excel that to a point where, you know, companies are believing in me to be that person or that voice or that face, or whatever they want to deem it, there's no bigger honor to me. You know, I think that's one of the things, if you start to hear from your peers, that's the biggest accomplishment. Your peers will be the most honest with you, you know, for the most part, if you have good peers, and I do. So any place that I go, you know, I always try to just look at the locker room and read the room from there and keep it going from there. So to be able to do that with all these companies, that's a big honor for me.
Okay, so looking ahead, I always close all of my interviews with five super quick rapid fire questions. Okay, I've got yours queued up, ready to go. You ready? What's your favorite movie?
Borat.
Borat. Oh, that's out of left field. I haven't heard that one yet. I do love that movie. It was hilarious. You can't go wrong with it. It's up there with, like...
Hey, I said, hey, I was here at one point, AJ, man. Came up, man.
That's awesome.
I always catch that way on guard, man.
Okay, who's your favorite musical artist or performing group?
Well, you know, group, I was to go with Jackson 5. I love Jackson 5. You know, it gets me in a good mood, gets the day going. And music artist, that's a catch 22. I don't just have one, man. That's a catch 22. But LMA is definitely up there. I'm going to tell you that. That's my girl.
Nice. Do you have a favorite fast food?
Ooh. Wendy's.
Wendy's, that's a popular pick. I think they make the best fast food cheeseburger. That's my opinion.
Yeah,
they make the best fast food cheeseburger.
I think the fresher chicken nuggets kind of give it to me. No offense, McDonald's. You know, you're in an emergency run, but I think it feels like I'm just tasting cardboard sometimes. It doesn't have nothing to it, so I'm like, I can't vibe with it. But
see,
Wendy's always did your boy good.
See, I'm from Nashville, and it's a city that's known for fried chicken. So when I eat fried chicken, I expect good fried chicken. So I know what bad fried chicken tastes like. Not that sometimes. Yeah.
It's just thin you.
Yeah, sometimes McNuggets from McDonald's hit differently. If it's 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, it's a different kind of feel for it. But if I think good quality fried chicken, I don't think McDonald's. Not in most cases.
Yeah, exactly. no one is thinking that. I think it's been very weird over like the last 15 years. Like I said, this is where I feel old. I'm like, I talk to people now, like, yo, y'all don't remember when Dairy Queen just used to worry about dairy products? Like, it didn't have cheeseburgers and none of that? Dairy Queen was literally just an ice cream shop.
Before the grill and chill was ever a thing.
And then, bam. And I'm like, what in the world is happening? So you get some crazy stuff at the fast food places now. All
right, what's your dream match opponent? Any promotion, any time period, anywhere?
Bray Wyatt.
That's a great pick. And last question. Favorite finisher that isn't your own?
It's not my own. I hit it, but it's not my own. Definitely Canadian Destroyer.
That's a hell of a move.
Petey Williams, man.
Yeah. Excellent. Okay. Reverend Hunt, this is the opportunity for you to plug your stuff, tell everybody where to find you, where your socials are, and where to find everything STP.
Absolutely. Well, you can go on all social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, all that fun stuff. The Reverend Hunt right there. Follow all the guys. Just type in Big Bad Kaiju on all social media, Prolific Moses on all social media, and then Shane216 Taylor on all social media. You'll be able to find us. And also, listen, it's always at heart. So we're going to squash this right now. Khan is still a part of the Shane Tip Moses family. That's blood. We talked about it. That's family. So make sure to follow him on social media as well and support his career at AEW.
Absolutely. Also, big shout out to Prolific Moses, as Botch Pots and Share Shots is his athlete sponsor tonight, STP versus Takeover.
I did see that. Listen, yeah. You guys made a smart business move on that one, man. Moses is going to tear it up, and then he's teaming with O'Shea.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, the boys got something coming. So you know where I am. I might be biased, but Moses and O'Shea going to tear it up tonight.
They're going to have
you got a good pick with Moses.
They're going to have a hell of a fight. When I got to sit down with the Faceless Ones with Jocko and Face, they're ready for it. But when I had the opportunity to jump on Moses' athlete sponsor, I was like, absolutely zero questions asked for the event. So I got behind you guys for sure. Reverend, I appreciate you very much taking some time out of such a busy day and stopping by and chatting about some wrestling with me, sir.
Yes, sir, man. Thank you, man. Hopefully it's not the last.
Yes, sir.
Recording stopped.